Welcome to the Daily Reminder Network.
Sunnah Revival by Sheikh Mu'iz Bukhari.
Sunan relating to Ramadan, part 2.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is Mu'iz Bukhari, recording for the Daily Reminder Network. This episode is a continuation of the previous episode where we touched on the Sunan and etiquettes regarding the noble month that we are in. So to continue the list, think of me as your Ramadan dietitian, and here is my prescription. Try as much as possible to avoid eating very oily and spicy foods for sahur and iftar. Now this is to avoid gastritis, acid reflux, etc. Instead, opt for more wholesome, filling and healthy food like colorful fruits, vegetables and whole grains. And remember, moderation is key. Avoid stuffing yourself so much that you cannot even budge from your dining area, let alone think about Salatul Fajr or Salatul Taraweeh. So by doing this, you help your body to be in a very comfortable and relaxed state during the day so that you can involve yourself in various good deeds. And so that too much of time is not spent on preparing various dishes and in consuming them. For after all, Ramadan is not a month of feasting, rather it is a month of fasting and ibadah. And secondly, it is of utmost importance that we keep our bodies well hydrated by consuming sufficient amount of liquids, especially fresh water, during sahur and iftar. Once again highlighting the importance of staying away from packaged and processed food, fizzy drinks, etc. that is most of the time filled with all kinds of preservatives and artificial additives, which result in the building up of thirst during the day and that bloated up feeling during Salatul Taraweeh. Moving on to touch on an important sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, and that is to refrain from obscene, offensive and vulgar talk such as swear words, cursing, etc. He ﷺ is reported to have said, and the narration goes along the lines of these words, "Fasting is like a shield, so there should be no obscene or offensive talk or behavior. If a person tries to fight with you, argues with you, or insults you, you should say very calmly, 'I am fasting, I am fasting.'" Now, what is important to understand at this point is the goal behind fasting. The goal behind fasting is not only to stay away from food, drink, and sexual pleasure, but rather it is upon a person to stay away from all kinds of obscene and vulgar behavior. Think of it as a 30-day training camp to train you for the rest of the year. Sometimes people only reflect on the following factors that invalidate an individual's fast, such as consuming food and drink, sexual relations, masturbation, cupping, vomiting intentionally, menstruation, etc. But they tend to remain oblivious of a second category that strips their fasting of all good and rewards, even though it may not nullify it completely according to the majority of the scholars. But still, a minority of the scholars hold the opinion that obscene language, backbiting, etc. does nullify the fast of an individual. So why on earth risk this valuable month? The Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said, "Whoever does not give up false speech and acting upon it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no need of him giving up his food and drink." The hadith is recorded in the book of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari radiallahu anhu is reported to have said, "When you fast, let your hearing, your sight and your tongue fast from lying and sin. Stop abusing your servants, i.e. your employees, and be peaceful and dignified on the day when you fast. Do not let the day when you do not fast and the day when you fast be the same." Allahu Akbar, a beautiful piece of advice. Now the next beautiful sunnah on the list is Salatul Taraweeh. It is a sunnah established according to scholarly consensus, and it is permissible to offer this prayer alone or in congregation. But which is better? There are two well-known opinions in regard to this matter, and the more favorable opinion is that praying it in congregation is way better than offering it alone. Use Taraweeh as an opportunity to listen and ponder on the beautiful and powerful words of our Maker. Don't think of it as something cumbersome and backbreaking. Instead, enjoy it and you will notice your levels of spirituality soaring, inshallah ta'ala. Having said that, we conclude today's episode by asking Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive all of our sins during this blessed month, and may He help us all to make the best out of the few days that we have remaining of this noble month. Ameen. Stay tuned for more Sunnah Revival episodes every Wednesday, and talk to you all in the next one, inshallah ta'ala. Please don't forget to share this video around as much as possible. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Support the Dawah. Donate now. Go to thedailyreminder.org/donate.